Hey, hey friends, it's Corey from Hey Let's Make Stuff. I am back with a Cricut Design Space tutorial. It's been a while since we've done one of these, but there is a new feature and I'm really excited to share it with you today. This new feature is called the Create Sticker Tool. So this allows you to create easy stickers within Cricut Design Space with a bunch of different options. We're gonna go through all of them, so let's get started. To begin, I have a free file for you for this project that I'm using. It is a PNG file, so a printable file versus a cut file. You can go ahead and download that in my craft library. To get to my craft library, just go to heyletsmakestuff.com/library. There you can request the password if you don't already have it. Then you can go back to that same page, enter the password, and you'll get into my craft library. This file is C478, Cricut 478. So there are two ways to find this in my craft library. The first is to scroll down just a bit and click on the SVG button. This will pop you down on that same page to the SVG section where you can grab this file C478. You can also use the search function on your computer. If you're on a Mac, you can use Command F. If you're on a PC, you can use Control F. And then you can just search for C478 and you'll be taken directly to that file. Under C478, you'll find three links. The first link is the download for this file. Click on that link and it will download a zip with these files in it to your hard drive. The second link is to the blog post for this video, and the third link is actually this video. If you ever have any problems accessing anything in my craft library, go ahead and give me an email at hello@heyletsmakestuff.com and we'll get you sorted. You're just going to need a handful of things to make these stickers today. Of course, you're going to need your Cricut. You can use any Cricut Maker machine, any Cricut Explore machine, Cricut Joy Extra, but you can't use the little Cricut Joy just because it doesn't have print then cut capabilities. You're also going to want a green cutting mat as well as your printable material. So here I am using Cricut printable vinyl. They actually have a lot of printable materials, a lot of new ones. I just don't happen to have any of them, so I am using their regular printable vinyl, which I actually really do like. And then you will also need a printer. My printer is actually on the other side of the room. I have an HP Envy and I really like it for projects like this. Let's learn how to make stickers by popping into Cricut Design Space. If you've been in Cricut Design Space lately, you'll notice that it has had some upgrades and changes. Almost everything functions similarly, but you may have to poke around a bit to find what you're looking for. As of the filming of this video, the Create Sticker function is part of beta, and so you're going to need to turn on beta Cricut Design Space to be able to access it. Soon this will move to the larger feature set, and then after that it will move to mobile, but for now you'll have to use beta. If you don't have beta selected, you'll do that in the menu. So one of the things that has changed here in Cricut Design Space is that we used to have our drop-down menu for settings in the upper left over here. That has now been moved to the upper right. So I'm going to click this little arrow and I'm going to click settings. And then here in the Design Space settings, you can change your application experience to beta. This just means you're going to get things before they are released. These things can often be glitchy, but this is how Cricut can test certain functions and tools to a wider audience to figure out what they need to fix before launching it to their entire audience. Note that if you didn't have beta checked before and you check it now, Cricut Design Space is going to restart. So make sure that you don't have any unsaved projects over here on your canvas. But once you select beta, it will restart and then you will be able to access this tool. Like a bunch of the new tools that Cricut is coming out with, this is only available to Cricut Access members. They are really pushing that Cricut Access membership. I think it's about $10 a month right now. And honestly, I think it's a pretty good deal for a lot of crafters, especially if you don't want to buy or create your own designs. They have an enormous image library for you to choose from. And with the membership, you can basically use almost everything in that library as part of your membership. If you don't have Cricut Access, you can do something similar using the offset tool. I will go ahead and link to some content about that. But really, this Create Sticker tool does have some features that aren't available anywhere else in Cricut Design Space. You can use the Create Sticker tool with images within Cricut Design Space, so you can use it with both print then cut images as well as with different cut images. And you can also use it with images that you upload. So I'm going to go ahead and start by uploading some of the images that you're getting for free with this video. In Cricut Design Space, I'm going to go to Upload, and I'm going to go to Upload Image. I'm going to browse and find the image I want to upload. Next, you'll see the screen for Upload Image. This is going to be a printable file, so I'm going to choose Complex and click Continue. Here's where you will remove any background your image has. My image actually doesn't have a background. I designed these without a background. So you can see that here by this sort of checked pattern in the back. If you're using a different image and you have a white background or other background, you can use the tools over here in the background remover to remove that background so that your stickers are actually cut around the edge. I'm going to hit Apply and Continue. From here, I'm going to select Print Then Cut Image and click Upload. From here, I can add my images to my canvas. When they come onto my canvas here, they're going to be very large just because I wanted you to be able to use them for other things if you'd like. I'm going to change the width to just 2 inches. We're going to make them quite a bit smaller. I'm also going to zoom in a bit just to make them easier to see. And we'll just line them up here. 1, 2, 3. Cute little neighborhood. I have three houses here because we're going to make three different types of stickers. So I'm going to select the first house here and I'm going to click Create Sticker. And here you will see again that it is in beta. So if you get glitches, that's why. You'll see two different types of stickers here, die cut and kiss cut. So the die cut sticker cuts all the way through the material, whereas the kiss cut sticker only cuts through that printable layer, leaving the liner intact. So we're going to do die cut for our first image here. And here you'll see some options. Right now I do not have a border. So if I wanted to apply it this way, it would cut around the edge of my sticker with no border. But if I want to add a border, I've got a couple options, thin, standard, wide, and then you can make a custom size as well. I'm going to choose standard. And you can see over here that it has added that border. You can change the color of the border fill if you'd like. And then there's also a cut interior shapes option. So I don't have any interior shapes on here, but let's say you were cutting a big letter A, for example, you could do cut interior shapes and it would cut out that triangle at the top of the A. And you'll see a couple of things here. The first is that we have this dark gray outline that is indicating that we have a die cut sticker. Over here in the layers panel, you'll also see that it has been turned into a sticker that is print then cut. Now let's do a kiss cut sticker. So I'm gonna click my second house here. I'm gonna go to create sticker. Kiss cut. Now we have even more options here. So I am going to choose that same standard border. Again, you can also change the border fill color and cut those interior shapes if you have them. For this one, I'm not going to choose die cut edge. We'll do that for the next one. So I'm going to go ahead and hit apply. Now it's a little hard to see, but you can see that the first image has a slightly darker gray outline here than the second image. And this is indicating that the darker gray is going to cut all the way through the liner and leave this as a single piece, whereas the lighter gray is just going to cut through that top vinyl piece, leaving the liner intact. So you can see both of them here when we do our third sticker. So I'm going to click here on my third house. I'm going to go to create sticker. I'm going to go to kiss cut once again. I'm going to choose that standard border. And I'm going to choose that die cut edge and click apply. Now you can see I actually have two borders here. So the outer border is that darker gray. That's going to cut all the way through. This lighter border is just going to kiss cut so I can remove just the sticker. So that's basically how to use the tool. Let's go ahead and actually make our project. I'm going to click make in the upper right. Projects are now automatically saved. So I'm going to click save and I'm just going to call this house stickers. Click save. And then I'll see all of my houses laid out on the same mat here. I'm going to create two copies just so I don't waste a bunch of my material here. Perfect, just like this. I think I can actually squeeze these a little higher up here. Just turn this one like this and fit it right there. Don't know why I thought it needed to go on its side there, but that'll work. I could probably fit more houses down here, but we're just gonna go with this. For this, you do not need to mirror your project. Once you have a layout you like, you can go ahead and click continue. Here in the final screen, you can send this to your printer. So I'm going to click send to printer. This will open up that print setup. You can keep your bleed checked if you'd like. It doesn't really matter because it's adding a bleed to your white outline anyway. If you're not using that outline or that border, definitely keep this checked because if you don't, you may end up with some white edges around the edge of your image. And I'm also going to use my system dialog box. For this, I'm using my HP Envy Pro, and I like to be able to change my print quality using that system dialog box. So I'm going to click print, and in this print dialog box, I can change my quality to best. For the materials, I'm going to click browse all materials. I think I'm using this printable vinyl with the gray liner. It sort of has a darker white, it's barely gray on the back, but it worked in my test, so I'm going to select that, and I'm going to click done. You can adjust your pressure for both the kiss cut and the die cut here. If for some reason when you're doing your tests, you find that something's cutting through. So I did actually find that my kiss cut pressure was a little high, so I'm going to choose less. Now it is time to cut our stickers. So I have my printed sticker sheet here. I'm gonna go ahead and place it in the upper left-hand corner of my Cricut mat, just like this. If you're having a hard time getting something to stick, you can use a brayer. Then I'm gonna go ahead and put it in my machine. When I click that go button on my Cricut machine, the sensors inside the Cricut are gonna read these little registration marks and it's gonna find out exactly where to cut. Now, I have set my calibration several times trying to get this right, but in all of my tests, I found that my calibration still was a little bit off. That could just be a part of the beta testing of this particular material. Sometimes that calibration is just really difficult to get right. So hopefully it works a little bit better for you, but we'll see how it goes with this particular cut. my Cricut has cut my project. The easiest way to get things off a Cricut mat is to flip it over and then use your hand here, and you can see that some of my stickers are coming up, which is what we want. Set this aside. So if you look in the overhead view, I actually have exactly what I thought I was going to get here. I did want to say something about the quality of the cutting around the edge of these stickers. Because these are sort of hand-drawn images, the edges are not perfectly straight like an SVG, which causes that offset to create sort of, I don't know, they're sort of rough edges. So they may look okay, but I will say they feel like a little bit dusty. I think that's the only way to put it. And that is just because it is not 100% like a really tidy file. But I did get exactly what I thought I was gonna get here. So to start off, we have the full die cut sticker here. So this cut all the way through the liner sheet here. And you can see when I peel it back here, I have the liner here and I have my sticker. Next up are the Kiss Cut stickers, which are actually still attached to my liner, which is exactly what I was expecting here. So here I can go ahead and peel them up just like this. So before, it was actually cutting just a little bit of the liner in the corners, which is why I used less pressure, and that actually worked really well. So this is really good for creating sort of a whole sheet of stickers. I will often do a whole sheet and then cut off the registration marks, and that works really well. So this worked out just like I expected it to work. And then over here we have the Kiss Cut die cut stickers. So around the edge we were die cut, we went straight through the liner, and then just inside that border we have our Kiss Cut sticker. So I hope you can see this in the overhead view here. I still have some of the actual vinyl piece around the edge, and then here I have my sticker. One really interesting thing I found with this is that I was able to cut all three of these stickers and all three of these processes on a single piece of vinyl. Pretty much every other time in Cricut Design Space, you can't do more than one sort of operation at a time. And here I was able to do Kiss Cut, Die Cut, and Kiss Cut, Die Cut. So really it's only two operations, but still, the fact that it made three different types of stickers on one single sheet is something I don't think we've actually seen from Cricut before. And I'm hoping that means that maybe we'll be able to do multiple cut types sometime in the future. I don't know, we'll see. But I did find that really interesting. So overall, I had a really good experience using this tool. I know things in beta can be really glitchy, and I did run across a few things when I was testing it originally. It did actually crash Cricut Design Space at one point, and I had to restart, which was kind of annoying. And then at one point when I was doing my tests, I actually got a warning about a warning. So down at the bottom, it said check warnings in the layers panel, but there were no warnings there. So I don't really know what that was about, but it's just one of those things that when you're using one of their beta tools or processes, that you may run across these sort of glitches as they work through things. Finally, I do want to hop back into Cricut Design Space for just a minute to talk about the difference between offset and using this Create Sticker tool. So here I have a cut file in Cricut Design Space. This is a Design Space file, and it's a cut file. So if I click on the first roller skate here, and I choose Die Cut, now you'll notice that it automatically flattened this image and turned it into Print Then Cut. Even though I can select the individual pieces of this, I can't edit the colors anymore. But if I click the second roller skate and I choose offset, and I give it a similar offset to what I have here for my sticker, maybe like a little bit less here, I do have weld offsets checked here, meaning it's only offsetting the entire thing, not each individual piece here. And I'm gonna click apply. Now to start, it gives you that black offset, so I'm gonna change that to white. And then you'll notice that this offset here is still all cut files. So I can basically make it identical to the sticker file by selecting all and clicking flatten. So this is a way to create a similar sticker file without having access to that Create Sticker tool. That being said, you don't have access to the die cut or kiss cut options. Depending on your material, you can set it for a kiss cut, which is what you might set printed vinyl to, or you can set it to something like cardstock and it will die cut it thinking that it's cardstock. So the two tools are similar, but the Create Sticker tool just gives you more options. I hope you found this video about using the Create Sticker tool in Cricut Design Space helpful. If you have any questions about using this tool, go ahead and leave those down in the comments. If you found this video helpful or inspiring, I would love for you to give it a like. Follow my channel for more Cricut, sublimation, and laser content. I'll see you next week.